I think my longevity in my career is due to this little personality quirk I have that just won't quit, even though I sometimes have good reason to, or all the signs say that I should. I just don't quit. And I think that for the 7 years that I was pretty horrible at this sport, the one thing I continued to do was I kept showing up and going to the track. And I had like a weird reason why I kept showing up, but I had a reason why. And that's why I try to impress on a lot of younger athletes, like, find out a reason why you're doing this, because that why could be the thing standing between you and leaving the sport completely. For me, when it wasn't going so well, my why was like, look, I was once world champion. People are still paying me to show up. I can make enough money to pay tuition, and then I can graduate, and then I can move on. So that little superficial thing was my why and was enough to keep me from quitting. At the same time, no effort is wasted. If you're going to the track every day and you are working every day, you're not wasting anything. You're actually making deposits into the bank of you, basically. And so eventually, I was able to tap into that and start performing well, but it really came down to just not quitting. I'm unguarded in my responses and interactions with the press, I think, because I'm completely annoyed when I read or see interviews where athletes are not. It's because I'm in this thing too. Like, it's been 13 years of being on the circuit. I'm here. I know what it's like. So to watch an athlete stand there and say something that's just like, get the can opener out and pull out a response, I'm just like, it's doing a disservice not only to the athlete because they've completely removed their personal experience and personality from the response, but it's doing a disservice to the fans who actually bothered to tune in to hear what you have to say about your event or your performance, and to upcoming athletes who will Google you, who will YouTube you, and try to see how, let me see how Tiana handled that L she took last week. And if I stand up there and say something as cliche as like, oh, it just wasn't in the cards for me today, who learned anything from that response? And so I learned that in order to fully embrace my journey and to pay it forward, you have to be honest and then bring your experience to everything, because that's what it means to be human, and most definitely the most impactful part about being an athlete. There isn't another athlete that I look up to and kind of get that same vibe from, that the separation between self and track is so clear that they could just walk away. But I learned this from yoga, actually, which seems like a very random thing. But in the study of yoga, you are supposed to come to it completely separate from the fruits of your labor. Like, you practice just for the sake of the practice. You work just to do the work. And so as I did my deep dive into yoga philosophy, I really could see the parallels between how that was helping me with my mental health when it comes to track and field. Because there have been many times where a meet director said I wasn't worth the appearance fee I was asking for. And then I would take that, internalize it, and suddenly I felt like I wasn't worth something, which is completely ridiculous, but something we all do all the time in any of our given professions, right? So now, I think through my study of yoga specifically, I'm just like, look, I'm gonna go to the track today, I'm gonna do this work, and maybe I will get the results that are favorable, and maybe I don't, but I got out there and I did the work, and I'm really grateful for that. And another thing that really helped me get to that point was how horrible my season was last year, because there is no better way to figure out who you are than when the crutch of good performances is ripped away from you. And I think I had a whole year of practice at finding out who Tiana the person was outside of who Tiana the performer was. All of my career has been my therapy, always running. They're either running away from something or running towards something, but you are always running. And when he told me that, I was like, you know what? I've always used track and field that way. I've been always using it as a way to prove myself or to validate something or to prove someone wrong all the time. It's only now that that started to shift for me and is addressing a different form of mental health. But I think for maybe at least 12 of the 13 years I've been doing this as a professional, it's been about you know, kind of propping me up mentally and kind of just being that crutch for me. And I'm happy that my relationship with the sport is a lot healthier now, but it hasn't always been, and it's definitely been the thing that's held me together for a long time. I would tell 19-year-old Tiana that just won world champs in Helsinki in 2005, that even though everything just changed, nothing changed. And to stay the course and stay consistent. Because what I learned looking back is that because I believed that everything had changed, I changed everything and basically contributed to the destabilization of Tiana. And I think had I just stayed calm and steady, we would be having a totally different conversation now.